When I look at the Sugimoto painting, I'm struck immediately by the tragedy of the scene. You know, this is a family that's been displaced. You see their little bit of earthly goods that they've brought with them. And there's a sense of anguish in the figures, the way they are depicted.
When the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor, our west coast became a potential combat zone. Living in that zone were more than 100,000 persons of Japanese ancestry. We knew that some among them were potentially dangerous. Most were loyal. But no one knew what would happen if Japanese forces should try to invade our shores. Military authorities therefore determined that all of them, citizens and aliens alike, would have to move.
In the midst of wartime panic about the possibility of Japanese people being involved in supporting the Japanese in the war effort, 110,000 people of Japanese descent were incarcerated in various parts of the country, including two camps here in Arkansas. And among those people was a budding artist by the name of Henry Yuzuru Sugimoto.
And Sugimoto was an artist that was born in Japan, came to the United States in 1919 after his parents had already arrived, went to what is now the San Francisco Art Institute and was trained there, and then eventually ended up in Jerome at the internment camp.
Henry later remarked that he felt an artist's sense of purpose to record and document the things that were going on to him and members of his community. And so he began to paint, and he painted experiences in the early camps on whatever scraps of paper and canvas that he could find. And then as he was sent out to Arkansas, he began to paint the arrival in the camps as arrival in Jerome documents.
In 1944, Hendrix artist Louis Friend, Elsie Bates Friend, and then Floyd Catherine Hansen, they visited Jerome Camp and they saw the work of Henry Sugimoto, and so they decided to host an exhibition. They were able to get Sugimoto released and they brought him here for the exhibit and showcased his work.
And then they acquired that piece out of that exhibition, which I think it's probably a really stellar example of his work.
This painting is a wonderful piece to have at Hendrix. In addition to Henry Sugimoto's inspiring story of determination and resilience in the face of a real time of crisis, it also shows a little bit about what our Hendrix community way back in the 1940s was willing to do when it saw injustice.
And I think that's kind of the seminal moment. That exhibit was kind of the first steps towards kind of this rebellion, this protest against the internment of the Japanese people, but also a way to highlight it through art. I think that kind of embodies the spirit of Hendrix, and it continues to this day, I think.
It's been wonderful to have this painting on our campus. It's a beautiful and striking piece, but it also really does call to our students, to our faculty, to members of our community to remember the responsibility that we have to help those in need, to reach out in times of crisis, and that we really can make a difference if we're willing to engage and do the things that we know to be right.